You remember last time, I told you that by the end of today's class, you should be able to frame really basic sentences on your own. Okay, this is just second class, but if you understand whatever we are going to learn, okay, then yeah, whatever we are going to learn, then you should be able to frame basic sentences on your own. Okay, but one more thing. You should mute yourself unless and until you want to say something. Okay. Yeah. So mute yourself, and obviously you can unmute yourself whenever you have a doubt or question. Okay. Or when I ask you something. Okay. Now, so see, when the first thing first is we are going to make some sentences. Okay. We are going to learn to make sentence. So what is the basic structure in a sentence is generally there is a subject. With subject, there is a verb, and then there is an object and things like that. Now, this object and other things, object is nothing but just the vocabulary most of the time. Okay, so we are going to initially focus on these two things, subject and verb. Okay, so now let's first move on to subjects. Okay, now I would ask you to please unmute yourself, okay, and start reading whatever I write.
If do free या सी एस एर सी एस वियर ईयर सी
करेक्ट ओके सो दिस आर सो सी सब्जेक्ट सो इन इंग्लिश ऑल्सो वी हैव दिस सब्जेक्ट यू नो लाइक आई यू ही शी इट वी दे ओके सो फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इज हाउ टू से दिस आई यू ही शी इट दे सो एंड सो फोर्थ ओके सो इश ओके एज यू सेड इश इश मीन्स आई ओके जस्ट गिव मी वन सेकंड या इश मीन्स आई नाउ डू डू मीन्स यू सिंगुलर इनफॉर्मल डोंट वरी आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज इट ओके जी जी ऑल्सो मीन्स यू सिंगुलर बट फॉर्मल एडजीएस ही शी इट वियर वी ईयर यू प्लूरल इनफॉर्मल एंड जी यू प्लूरल फॉर्मल एंड जी दे ओके सो नाउ इफ यू सी केयरफुली ओके देन See, and I recommend you, and not just recommend you, I would rather insist you that when you learn this subjects, okay, or when you know, remember these subjects, you should also do it in the exact same manner, okay? That you, if you see the way I have written them, so there are total 8 subjects, 4 on the left-hand side and 4 on the right-hand side, okay?
Yes.
Yeah. So on the left-hand side, if you see, they all are singular, correct?
Yes.
On the right hand side, okay, they all are
Plural.
respective plurals. They are plurals, but not just plurals, they are respective plurals. Okay, so plural of I is we, plural of you is you, plural of he, she, it is they. Okay, and why have we done this? Because as you can see, there are two different types of you. Okay, and so you know, just to avoid the confusion, because people do get confused in this ear and Z and things like that. Okay. And to avoid the confusion, if you remember it like this, you would definitely avoid the confusion. Okay. Forever. Just give me 1 second. Okay, yeah. So each do G R G S G R E R G D. Okay, so these are our subsets. Now there are two, three small and important stuff. Okay, in this. Now first thing is, if you see, four times we come across this word Z Z Z Z. Correct?
Yes. Okay.
So the question automatically becomes that then how would I know? If I am writing this sentence, you know, I'm using these words in sentence, okay, how would I know which Z I'm using? Whether it's you or whether it is she or it is they. How would I know? Okay. So see, there is one small idea you get here, that you see, whenever Z means you, whenever Z means you, this S is capitalized.
Oh.
Do you see that? In she and they, S is not capital. Okay. In she and they, S is not capital. But in you, okay, S is capitalized. So that is to say, whenever you want to say you, okay, and for that if you are using Z, regardless when it appears in the sentence, whether at the beginning or in the middle or at the end, S is always capitalized.
Okay.
But still, problem is not solved, you know. But because, you see, when we write a sentence, and if I'm using this subject at the beginning of the sentence, then at the beginning of the sentence, anyways, the first letter of the first word is capitalized.
Yes.
Correct? So whether it is you or she or they, S will always be capitalized if it is at the beginning of the sentence. Correct? Then how would I know which one is it? Well, we will learn that. We'll solve that issue, okay? We will learn that, how to recognize which one. But that is one important point that we'll learn, okay?
Yes.
Second thing, as you can see, there are two different types of you, okay? You informal and you formal. Correct?
Yes.
Now, in English, we don't have this. In English, you is you. There is no such thing as formal and informal. Okay?
Yes.
But if you think carefully, in our own mother tongue also, we have two different types of you, formal and informal. Can you think of? Can you tell me which?
In Hindi, we have tum and aap.
Exactly. Exactly.
Tu ane tame.
Perfect English, right? Tu ane tame. Yeah? Okay. So which one do you think is tu or tum?
Do is tu and exactly. Si is tame.
Tame. Understood?
Yes. See?
So if you are talking with your, let's say, parent, let's say your father, okay? So which you would use?
Si.
Si. If you are talking with your boss?
Yes. Si.
If you are talking with, let's say you have a younger brother or younger sister, then?
Do.
If you are talking with a stranger? Completely unknown person?
See.
Clear? We know that already. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah? Okay. So that's it. These are the subjects. Can you just say the subjects once again very quickly? What are the subjects? Okay.
Is, do, z, r, z, s, wear, ear, z, and z.
Correct. Okay? Now, so as we said in the subject, okay, so in the sentence, we have subject, verb, and object is nothing but the vocab, as I said. Subject and verb is something if we master, we can make sentence, to be frank. Okay, so subject, out of this subject, we have already seen. Now, let's take up verb. Okay, so verb. Now, before we move on to verb, okay, let me tell you one thing. See, verb. Just like in English, okay, in German also, there are two types of verbs, okay. First is regular verb and the second is irregular verb, okay. Now, before we move on to this, okay, I have a question for you. Can you tell me what is the meaning of regular? What is the meaning of regular?
Regular means you can see in a more frequency. just like it is just like normal in the sense in more and more vocabulary or in more and more verb I would see this kind of structure, whereas irregular means it would
listen
see.
listen see I'm not asking you part what is the meaning of regular verb no okay,
okay.
I am asking you simply what is the meaning of this word regular. What is the meaning of regular?
Regular means it follows certain rules and
perfect.
It would
that's it yeah perfect okay, so regular means anything that follows rule. Okay, this word regular, it is derived from the French word règle. Règle means rule, law, Gujarati ma kahe to niyam. Yeah, so anything that follows some sort of rule is called regular. Okay, so what would be the meaning of regular verb then?
The verb which follows certain rules.
Exactly, perfect. Okay, so regular is anything that follows the rule. So by that definition, regular verbs would be the verbs which follow the rules. Which rules we don't know, but some rule. Okay, doesn't matter. So when I say, let's say, you know, Parth is a very regular person. So what do I want to say? That what do I want to say is this: that Parth follows the rule. Maybe the rule of being punctual. Okay, or when I say this clock is, you know, very regular. So maybe I want to say the clock follows the rule of ticking at every 1 second. So which rule? We don't care. Some rule. Okay, but some rule they must be following. That's why they are called regular verbs. Okay, and so contrary, what would be the meaning of irregular verb?
The verb which would not follow that rules, which are made. So
exactly, the verb that do not follow the rules. Correct. Okay, we don't care which rules. Yeah. Okay. So now, let's just think it through. Okay, let's just take this one step forward in thinking. So when I say, let's say there is any verb. Okay, let's say any verb. There is any verb V. I don't care which verb is it. I'm just saying there is a verb V. I'm saying that this verb V is a regular verb. Okay.
Yes.
So logically thinking, by the very definition of it, I am saying this verb V is a regular verb, and since it's a regular verb, it means it must be following some rules.
Yes.
Correct? That's
yes.
So for this verb to be a regular verb, there must be, first of all, some rule or a set of rules in the first place.
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay, and so there are some rules or a set of rules, and since this particular verb is following those rules, okay, I'm calling this verb is a regular. Correct?
Yes.
Yeah. So what are those rules? Okay, which what are those rules? So those rules are called rules of conjugation. Okay, rules of
conjugation.
Rules of conjugation. Now, let's understand this term first. Okay, this term, conjugation. What is the meaning of the term conjugation?
Conjugation means like adding something.
Exactly. Okay, the verb conjugation is a noun. Okay, the verb form is to conjugate. Okay, to conjugate is to mix up something or to add something. Okay, now in a sentence what are we adding? So we are adding a verb to the subject. Okay.
Yeah. Yes,
so subject and verb, we are mixing, we are joining them. Correct. Okay, so now what happens actually in a sentence, that whenever I use a verb, okay, now can you tell me the subjects first once again?
Is, do, ze, are, see, as, fear, ear, ze, and ze.
Perfect. Yeah, so ear, ear, ze,
see,
ze. Correct. Now
yes.
So in conjugation, what are we conjugating? We are joining. Conjugation means to join, to mix, to add. Yeah. So we are joining subject and the verb. Okay.
Yes.
So whenever I use a particular verb, okay, and we have total 8 subjects, okay. So depending on with which subject I am using the verb will get modified.
Oh.
Okay. And the rules according to which this verb gets modified, those rules are called rules of conjugation.
Conjugation.
Okay. Let me first give you a small kind of idea about rules of conjugation in English. Okay. So let's say in English, let's say the verb is play. Okay. Verb is
play.
So I play.
Play.
You
play.
He, she, it
plays.
Plays. Correct. Let's take the verb go in English. I
go.
You
go.
He, she, it
goes.
Goes. Correct. So you see what in, and so if you remember in school, we had learned that whenever we use the verb with third person singular, so that is he, she, it, whenever we use the verb with he, she, it, we have to add s or
yes.
Correct.
Yes.
Okay. So in English, there was only one rule of conjugation. So see, verb was getting modified. Verb was getting modified depending on which subject it is used. Correct? If the verb in English, it was used with he, she, it, then we had to add s or es. Correct? In English, we had only one rule. In German, we have 8 subjects and so 8 rules. That's the only difference. Okay.
Okay.
Now, let me just quickly say this thing again so that you understand it a bit better. Okay. So verb, we have seen that, I have told you that there are 2 types of verbs. In English also, we have 2 types of verbs. Okay. Regular and irregular. But what is the meaning of regular verb? So regular verb means verbs which follow the rules. But for verb to follow the rules, there must be some rules, first of all, that it has to follow. Okay. So what are those rules? So those rules are called rules of
conjugation.
And what does it mean, rules of conjugation? So verb, okay, verb when it is used with the subject. So depending upon which subject, depending on with subject that verb is getting used, the verb gets modified accordingly, according to the rules. Okay, those rules are called rules of conjugation. Clear so far?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Now let's let me tell you this. Now let's take a verb, okay? This. Can you tell me what is this? I mean, just read it. I mean, that's all.
Okay. Ahen.
Arey, there is G at the.
Okay. Gehen.
Gehen. Okay. Gehen means to go. Now see, there is one interesting thing in German language. Most of the time, almost always. Okay, all the verbs, they will end in en. Almost always. Okay, you remove that en from the verb and what is left?
Ge.
Ge. Correct? So whatever is left, that is called stamm. Stamm means stem, root, base. Okay, so can you tell me how do we find stamm from the verb?
By removing en from the end.
Correct. Okay, we remove en and then whatever is left is called stamm. Now see, this is not actually something very peculiar to German, okay, that ending with en. Okay, even in Gujarati, let's say any verb, you take any verb, it will always end in vu. Jambu, au, rambu, pivu, dodvu, umbu. You take Hindi. Okay, all the verbs, they will end in na. Khana, na, sona, jagna, uthna, betna, dorna. Okay, so that na. You remove that common part. Okay, so and then whatever is left is called stamm. So in German, that common part is en. We remove that and whatever is left is called stamm.
Stamm.
Understood?
Yes.
How to find stamm? Okay. Now, the rules are this. Okay, so with ish, it is stamm plus So in stam you will add e. Okay. So let's say the verb is this gehen. Gehen means to go. So with ish, if I have to use this verb, how can I use?
Gehe.
Gehe. Exactly. Ish gehe means I go.
Go.
Okay. With do, the rule is stam plus st. So do.
Gehst.
Gehst means.
You go.
You go. Z, it is infinitive form. Infinitive means verb in its original form. This entire verb. This entire verb in its original form. Okay. So gehen remains gehen. Okay. RZS. Stam plus T means.
Gate.
Gate. Can you gate. Tell me the meaning as well?
Okay. He, she, it goes.
He, she, it goes. Correct. We are infinitive. So?
So, we are gain or we go. Gain.
Yeah, we go. Next.
Ear gate means you go.
Correct.
Then see gain means you go. And then see gain means they go.
Correct. So now we come back to the problem that we had here, that how do I know whether it is you or she or they? Okay, because your if this Z is used at the beginning of the sentence, then it will always be capitalized. Correct? Yeah. If it is in the middle, then I know. Ki haan, if it is capital and it is in the middle or at the end, then I know this Z is definitely you. But if it's at the beginning, then how do I know whether it is you or she or they? So now you see here, if it is you, then the conjugation, the verb form that will follow the subject, it is infinitive. But if it is she, then the verb will end in T.
T.
Correct?
Yes.
So immediately I will know if the verb is ending in T, okay, and there is Z, okay, but immediately I would know, even if it is capital, immediately I would know that this is she.
T.
Correct?
Mm.
Yeah. But still the problem still remains between you and they.
Yes.
Okay. But since they have similar conjugation form, but see any no sentence is in isolation. Okay. So you get some idea from the context as well. So there are some sentences before that sentence. There are some sentences after that sentence also. So we immediately get to know whether we are talking about, second person or third person.
Third person.
Understood?
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So let's do just one more verb, okay? And you conjugate, okay? Let's say the verb is machen. Machen means to do or to make. So what you have to do, okay? You have to conjugate. Please pay attention to the terminology. You have to conjugate this verb. To conjugate means as the process that we did this year. Okay.
Yes.
The process that we have done here. Okay. So you have to conjugate this. Okay.
So can is, you is make do marked. See machen. ERC as marked.
RZ, not ER.
Oh. RC as marked. We are marking, ear marked, see the marking and the marking.
The marking, the marking. Understood?
Yes.
Yeah. So you will be given as a homework, a few verbs. Okay. I'm noting down a few of the verbs here. Okay. So what you have to do as a homework is you have to conjugate them. Okay. And you understand what do I mean? When I say you have to conjugate them, correct? So the same process that you did, okay, the same process you have to do for each verb. So, let's say So let me just note down few verbs. Can you please read them as well?
Common.
Common means?
To come.
To come. Okay.
Learning.
Learning means?
To learn.
To learn.
Drinking.
No.
To drink.
No, pronunciation is wrong.
Oh, okay. Drinking.
Drinking.
Wohnen.
Wohnen. Yeah.
Wohnen.
To live.
To live.
Okay.
Spielen. Heißen. Arbeiten.
Arbeiten. And the last one, let's say, okay.
Studieren.
Yeah. Correct. Now, by the way, let me tell you one more thing, that when you will be conjugating these two verbs, okay, which two verb? Heißen and arbeiten. Okay. Although these two verbs are regular verbs, when you will be conjugating these two verbs, you will feel, you know, like somewhere the rule should not be followed. You will feel, okay, something odd. Okay. Somewhere while conjugating, you will feel something is not right. You know, here I should not follow the rule. Although these two verbs are regular verbs, keep in mind. Okay. You will feel that the rule should not be followed. Okay. And it is your job, it's a part of your homework to tell me in conjugating which subject or subjects you think the rule should not be followed, and why do you think if the rule should not be followed, then why do you think the rule should not be followed here? Now, obviously, rule should not be followed, and so some exception will be there. So that exception, I will tell you. Some new thing will be there. So what will be that new thing? That I will tell you.
Okay.
But it is your job to tell me that while you will be conjugating, somewhere the rule will not be followed. Which subject the rule will not be followed? Why do you think it will not be followed?
Okay.
Okay. Clear?
Yes.
Any doubt?
In these two subjects, sir, it is, you said that the rule would not be followed, maybe not followed for some of the subjects, or I will, okay, I may fail. So why they are still called as a regular verb?
Well, because they are following this pattern. Simple, right? Because what is the meaning of any regular verb? Any regular verb, what is the meaning of regular verb? Please say it again.
Regular verb is the one which follows the rule of conjugation.
Exactly. And these two verbs are following the rules of conjugation. Okay. Oh. It's just that somewhere there will be minor tweaks. And for a reason. For a reason. Okay. You have to find that out. Okay. We will not mug that up. Okay. It's very logical. Okay. It's really very logical. Once you will start conjugating, you will feel. Okay. Intuitively. Yeah. Something is right. Okay.
Okay.
Now. Okay, so let's start. Now, we have learned subjects, we have learned verbs, okay, at least the regular verbs. We are ready to make some sentences. Let's give it a try, okay? Suppose you want to say that I learn German.
Ich lerne Deutsch.
Ich lerne Deutsch, perfect. Let's say you want to say, I drink tea.
Ich trinke Milk.
Tee. Ich trinke Tee. Tea is called Tee.
Oh.
Let's say you want to say that.
Yes, sir.
Tara, please, your voice is too loud. Disturbance, please.
एक्चुअल में हमारे विंडो ओपन है। Can you hear me?
Yes, yes. So let's say the sentence is we play cricket.
Okay. We spill in
cricket. How to say we?
Okay. We are spill in cricket.
We are spill in cricket. Let's say you want to say I live in Petlar, right?
Okay. Is wohne in Petlar.
Born in Petlar. Let's say you want to say I come from Petlar.
Is come
from
off,
is called
house.
Pronunciation A U out.
Is come off Petlar.
Is come house Petlar. Okay.
Petlar.
Suppose you want to say that I go to Ahmedabad.
Is gay hai
to here for two we will be using nak
is gay hai nak Ahmedabad
is gay nak Ahmedabad okay suppose you want to say that I am called and then your name I am called xyz it's like saying my name is xyz right It's the same thing. It's the same yes. meaning. Yeah. Okay.
Is Heiser part?
Is Heiser part? Okay. Suppose you want to say that I do the homework.
Is Marke house of Gabe?
Is Marke the
house of
the house of Gabe?
The house of Gabe.
Is Marke I do the homework? Right? Is Marke the house of Gabe? So, see, what you did just now is kind of you gave your small introduction that my name is so-and-so, I live here, I live at so-and-so place, I come from so-and-so place, I'm going to so-and-so place, I'm learning this, I'm drinking this, we are playing this, okay, and I'm doing so-and-so, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and I did not help you to do this.
Yes.
You made all these sentences on your own.
Yes.
And this is still just the second lecture. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. Did you feel any difficulty in this?
Till now, I don't feel any difficulty.
Okay. Perfect. Okay. So let me, yeah, just...